The BBC has reported that interest in Wigan Athletic is high. Over 60 parties have come forward and contacted the administrators about the club. These are not simple inquiries, non-disclosure agreements were issued and expressions of interest received. This is a far cry from when AFC Bournemouth went into administration more than a decade ago. Fast forward to our current coronavirus-impacted world, and the Cherries are spending their fifth year in the Premier League. They now have a player on loan at Wigan, Alex Dobre. Eddie Howe and his team have surely transformed Bournemouth, but the foundations of their success was negotiating administration in February 2008. Dean Court might not host Premier League fixtures next season given their relegation battle, but one thing is for certain, they've come a long way and are a team that's entrenched in the hearts of global fans on account of their battle against the odds. Wigan Athletic would want a similar outlook in a decade's time. The future is not our subject today, it's the past which has brought us here. It has the keys to unlock Wigan's present and shape their future. It sounds cliched, and it might be, but for a future that seems uncertain, it is a journey that we have to take. Because Wigan had risen through the lower echelons of English football under David Whelan, and one year after his sale of stake in the club, the Latics found themselves in unfamiliar territory. David Whelan purchased the club in 1995. The local millionaire had great ambitions for his local club and began in earnest. Using his Spanish connections, Roberto Martinez, Isidro Diaz, and Jesus Seba were brought to the club. The trio became famous as the Three Amigos, with Roberto Martinez entering local folklore when he took charge of the club. More on that later. Wigan showed improvement under Whelan and his appointments. Like all lower tier clubs, there was a manager merry-go-round, but investment into the club did not stop. There were gambles taken, some didn't pay off, and some paid handsome dividends. One of them was the appointment of Paul Jewell as manager. The former Latics forward was young and stepping in the footsteps of Steve Bruce. While the former Manchester United defender did not enjoy his stint at the DW Stadium, Jewell was a perfect fit. In the prior 6 years, Wigan became a League One mainstay, but Jewell would get them to the promised land in only the second time of asking. Promotion to the Championship was secured in the 2002-2003 season in record-breaking fashion. The side from Greater Manchester was back after accumulating 100 points. They were then put on the map as their EFL Cup run, then Carabao Cup, would see them defeat West Brom, Manchester City and Fulham en route to the quarterfinals. Their stay in the Championship was short as they won their second promotion in 3 years. For the first time in their 73-year history, Wigan Athletic would play in the Premier League. Chelsea and Manchester United were battled in a heated title challenge. All the while, Wigan enamoured rival fans with their rags-to-riches story. Whelan helped Jewell realise their aspirations, but the club never went beyond their means. Portsmouth would provide a cautionary tale, and heads at DW Stadium ensured everything remained in order. 8 glorious years were spent in the English top flight. Paul Jewell had left and the club was now being managed by Roberto Martinez. The Spaniard could not stave off relegation, but would provide Wigan with FA Cup glory. Ben Watson scored at Wembley Stadium to give Wigan's first major trophy. Manchester City could not stand in destiny's way. The victory meant that they'd become the first Premier League club to win the FA Cup and be relegated in the same season. 2 years after their ousting from the Premier League, Dave Whelan would vacate his chairman's role and appointed his grandson, David Sharp, as his replacement. Roberto Martinez had departed for Everton after their relegation, and Wigan had been relegated to League One. They never stay in the Championship for long. Sharp had huge boots to fill and a lot of question marks over his head as he took the reins of Wigan as a 23-year-old. Sharp had one thing similar to Whelan: he was shrewd with money and had asked clubs to control their spending in hopes of a best-case scenario. Sharp had dipped into the family's wealth to help the club out, but that trend could not continue for long. Given the club's location, commercial activities were sparse and they could not outspend those around them. So, after 4 years at the helm of Wigan, Sharp sold the Whelan family's stake in the club to Hong Kong-based International Entertainment Corporation, IEC, in a £22 million deal in the summer of 2019. The club were spending their first year back in the Championship. Sharp cited that the reason for the sale was inability to buy in the project. The best-case scenario hinged on Wigan getting back into the Premier League, and it was not a dream the family could fund. IEC would usher the club into the next stage, but it was not to be. The coronavirus pandemic took its toll, and IEC sold their majority stake to another Hong Kong-based entity, the Next Leader Fund. The decision would be ratified in a month after they passed the EFL owners and directors test, and shareholders of IEC, as well as the Hong Kong Stock Exchange, approved of the transaction. It was a step in the right direction as promises of financial support until the 2020-21 season were secured. It seemed that the Whelans' legacy of players and staff getting their due would be kept in these troubling times. However, it was not the case. In 6 days' time, the next leader fund would renege on their promises and the club were forced into administration. Wigan had enjoyed 24 years of stability under the Whelan family, and in 1 year it all came crumbling down. Wigan would become the first casualty of the coronavirus pandemic. They were on an unbeaten run of 9 games prior to the rumours and the news, and would suffer their first defeat. At the same time, around half of the club's non-playing staff were made redundant. After 24 years of stability, Wigan are facing their biggest battle. It can be argued that they got out at the right time, but no one could have predicted the pandemic and its resulting financial impact. IEC certainly didn't, but the next leader fund did, and there should be an investigation into their dealing of the whole fiasco. It would be quite some time until any such investigation gives an accurate picture of the situation. For the moment, Wigan have to complete the Championship season. They recorded their biggest league win as they thrashed Hull City 8-0 at the DW Stadium. The victory allowed them to stay in the Championship for another season, but with a caveat. They will not start the 2020-21 Championship campaign with a 12-point deduction as a result of going into administration, but will have reduced funds allocation with their adjusted 21st place finish. Current manager Paul Cook will have to worry about that in 2 months' time. At the moment, he has to finish the season and ensure he could scalp some good players in the transfer market. It would be a difficult task given players tend to stay away from clubs that have difficulty paying wages. To top it off, join an entity where the non-playing staff has been reduced so much that effective standards are difficult to uphold. Making matters worse is the fact that the Championship and Premier League vultures have begun to surround the club. Young Jensen Weir is the first one out of the club. The Wigan Youth Academy graduate holds the record of being their youngest ever player and will be on the books of Brighton and Hove Albion next year. He fetched a handsome £500,000 plus add-ons for Wigan, and it will help them greatly during this period, but more are on their way out of the club. United States men's national team member Anthony Robinson will surely head out. The seven-time capped international is a highly regarded commercial prospect and was an ever-present figure in Paul Cook's first 11. He could be a great backup option for Premier League sides, and if Chelsea sign him, it would be great to see him line up alongside international teammate Christian Pulisic on the left side, even if it is in lesser-known competitions. For Wigan fans, they will have to get used to this reality, especially for the near future. It'll be a miracle if Paul Cook could ensure another mid-table finish next season. The manager has done a remarkable job, and he can solidify his status in Wigan's history books by securing a Championship stay. This is their only target for the coming season. There is light at the end of the tunnel. There is interest in the club and it can come to fruition. Wigan Warriors, the rugby league football club, want to take them under their wing. The 2019 World Cup Challenge runners-up have the financial muscle to keep them afloat. Ian Lenegan is a native of Wigan and has significant clout in the English Football League on account of his stint as chairman in 2016. Ian bought the Wigan Warriors from Dave Whelan in 2007, and his ownership of prominent local sports franchises will come full circle with Wigan Athletic's addition. Here's to hoping for a bright future for Wigan.